What's going on, guys? Jacob over here. So, got a J.J. Watt update for you on this channel. The final update I'm going to do on J.J. Watt, because he has finally made his decision on where he's going to play next year. And it's not the decision that us Packer fans were wanting to hear, but he has chosen the Arizona Cardinals. 2 years, $31 million, $23 million guaranteed. He chose the money. And, hey, you know, I cannot fault him for doing that. As an NFL player, you have a limited amount of time to make money. And sure, you're making millions of dollars, but that's about the only time in your life that you're going to be making that much money. And, of course, you know, sponsorships after he retires, of course. But when you're an NFL player, you want to be able to make the most money you possibly can to last you the rest of your life. So I cannot fault him for taking what he is worth on the market, you know. $15, $16 million, teams are willing to pay that. It's a couple million less than he was making in Houston, but it's, you know, not that much of a difference. If he wanted to play with the Green Bay Packers, he probably would have had to take $5, $6 million less than he was made with the Cardinals. So that's a pretty significant amount of money, and I cannot fault him for, you know, taking the more money route. You know, I was kind of hoping that he was going to take a hometown discount, and I'm not going to lie, I'm kind of bummed that he didn't. He grew up as a Packer fan. He grew up in Wisconsin, played for the Badgers. You know, he made a ton of money in his time in Houston. I was hoping that he might take a few million dollars less to come play with Green Bay and have a better chance at a ring. And, of course, the Cardinals are a good team. Maybe they have a chance at a ring next year, but I feel like he probably would have been better with the chances at getting to a Super Bowl with a team like Green Bay or Buffalo or something like that, or Pittsburgh. But, you know, it is what it is, and he made his decision, and I'm glad that he made it early, so now we can start talking about other things, because I know I've been talking a lot about J.J. Watt on this channel the past few weeks, but now I can finally move on. We can move on as a whole, start talking about other free agents, start talking about the draft, because it is a big offseason upcoming for Green Bay, and there is going to be a lot of big decisions they make. Unfortunately, the Packers don't get J.J. Watt, but there are still plenty of other guys out there for them to consider. So, yeah, I mean, I'm sure a lot of Packer fans are going to be really, really upset about this. And like I said, I really don't think you can blame the player when they take their market value. Like I said, you know, NFL players' careers are usually short, so making the most amount of money that you can in that short period of time, I can't blame them for that. But, you know, as a Packer fan, I'm bummed out. I really am, because he would have looked amazing in the green and gold, you know, improving the team for sure and giving us a better chance at winning a ring, having him come out on the field, you know, for the Super Bowl and dominating and hoisting the Lombardi trophy. But it was all a pipe dream, and, you know, at the end of the day, him taking the money, best decision for him, for his family probably, for his future going forward. So, hey, it is what it is, like I said. So, anyways, guys, that's all I wanted to say in this video. Like I said, last J.J. Watt update. I certainly wish J.J. Watt all the best in Arizona, and I hope he does really well, because he still is one of my favorite players in the league, without a doubt. But in the meantime, guys, so thanks for watching. That's all I got to say in this video. Share your thoughts in the comments section below. Remember to keep it civil, and I'll see you guys next time. Go Pack, go.